Welcome back. I'm Dr. Swati Naik, and once again a warm welcome on Emcure AICOG TV. I'm pleased to have with me one of my favorite teacher, under whom I have learnt my medicine, Professor Emeritus Dr. P.K. Shah sir. Thank you so much, sir, for joining us on Emcure AICOG TV. Sir, you are the expert in ultrasonography. And the fetal medicine, yes,
right.
I have always listened to your lecture in all the conferences, and nobody can diagnose those critical conditions at a very early stage in a fetus. So we would like to have the insights on the ultrasonography in pregnancy.
Okay.
When to do, how many times to do, because nowadays with lot of commercial aspect coming in, it is at times becomes it is being asked for number of times when it is actually not needed.
Very true.
So how many times do you recommend ultrasonography during pregnancy?
Normally we ask for ultrasonography once for each trimester.
Mm-hmm.
Once in first trimester, once in second trimester, and once in third trimester. First trimester, normally we ask for early ultrasonography to see the viability of the fetus. But nowadays the whole thing has changed. We go for 11 to 13.6 weeks scan.
Mm-hmm.
So there we get complete knowledge of the fetus, the anatomy, any abnormality, etc. And we can do aneuploid scan, as we
mm-hmm.
call it, whether the baby has any chromosomal disorder or not.
At such an early stage, sir?
Absolutely. Now, the thing that was done earlier on at 18
yes.
weeks, 20
yes, sir,
weeks,
yeah.
22
yeah.
weeks has been brought down to around 11 to 14 weeks roughly. And majority of the congenital anomalies can be picked up at that point of time,
mm-hmm.
barring some of the organs which are not yet completely developed.
Mm-hmm.
Because the complete development occurs by about 20, 22 weeks, and especially cardiac abnormalities cannot be picked up till 22, 24 weeks. So
mm-hmm.
that is one area where we cannot pick up everything.
Mm-hmm.
But rest of the organs we can pick up early enough. And especially the Down syndrome, because we all know Down syndrome, trisomy 21, the markers can be picked up easily from 11 to 14 weeks scan. The second scan we ask for is around 18 to 20 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
Normally in international level they ask for anywhere between 20, 22, 24 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
But because in our country
mm-hmm.
the abortion can be carried out only up to 20 weeks,
mm-hmm.
we ask for an early scan around 18 weeks, so that
mm-hmm.
if patient has
mm-hmm.
any abnormality, the baby has mm-hmm. any congenital abnormality which thereby cannot survive ex utero
mm-hmm.
once she is born, then we can ask for termination of pregnancy
mm-hmm.
at that point of time, because we can do it before 20th week of gestation.
And we can justify also that we already
Absolutely.
Have the two scans in place.
Because nowadays you must have seen in newspaper, the ladies go to Supreme Court
yeah.
asking for permission to abort.
Yeah.
Now that is the situation. Foxy has already requested the Government of India, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, to extend the limit
mm-hmm.
under the certain circumstances
right.
to allow us terminate the pregnancy, because now so many cases are coming up for termination of pregnancy beyond 20 weeks
mm-hmm.
and genuine. The third ultrasound we ask for is around 32 weeks for growth of the baby, whether the baby is growing well or not, whether the lichen is alright or not, where is the placenta, whether the placenta is situated normally or abnormally, etc. So these are the three basic ultrasonographies we carry out. But suppose the patient doesn't want three ultrasounds for whatever reasons, if she feels that ultrasound can cause some damage to the baby, then we ask for one ultrasound, then it is 18 weeks ultrasound, because we can pick up majority of the congenital anomalies
mm-hmm.
by that time.
Okay.
And we always counsel the patient and tell her that cardiac anomalies cannot be picked up
before
it comes
18,
up yeah, by about 22, 24 weeks, whereby echocardiography of the fetus has to be done. And most of the patients never say no for ultrasonography nowadays, because they also have the knowledge that this is see-through technology. If you remember when we passed out MBBS, in third MBBS, we used to just palpate during
yes,
pregnancy.
Sir, yeah. You have also taught
us. It was more of a palpation.
Palpation, yeah.
Now here you see through the whole abdomen, not only the uterus, but also you can see each and every part of the fetus.
Right.
And that was not possible. The ultrasonography has totally revolutionized our practice in obstetric gynec and even in other fields also.
Sir, any specific tips when somebody is doing sonography, if an obstetrician and gynecologist is doing a sonography, to pick up any of the signs. I think in one of the lectures you were talking about this sign, finger being like this and...
Well, there are lots of things, you know. There was a time when myself and late Dr. M. Y. Rawat from Nayar Hospital, we used to go and talk for ultrasonography in obstetrics for 1 hour, mm-hmm. ultrasonography in gynec for 1 hour, mm-hmm. and that's all. But that was 30-35 years back. The whole thing has changed over a period of time.
Right.
For each topic, one can talk for 1 hour in gynec.
Oh my God.
That is a very big change. The technology has changed. It is now from two-dimensional ultrasound. It has come to color Doppler, three-dimensional ultrasound, four-dimensional ultrasound, contrast enhanced ultrasound.
Oh, that is also there now.
There are so many things coming up. There is nothing one particular thing, but if I have to advise gynecologists as regards ultrasound, they must follow PCPNDT Act absolutely religiously. There is no way you can get out of it. It is there for good. We have to bring up the ratio of female and male fetuses that are born, and they must follow PCPNDT Act absolutely religiously.
There is no excuse.
And number
in
two,
that, yeah.
Though by PCPNDT Act we are allowed to do ultrasound, because if you are MD or DGU or DNB, as per PCPNDT Act you are allowed. But unless you have undergone proper training, you will not be able to understand.
Absolutely.
So I think a training
is important.
Is a must.
Sir, what is the role of color Doppler? If you can just give us quick.
Okay, now color Doppler is just a superimposition of color on two-dimensional ultrasound. What imparts color on the machine is movement.
Mm-hmm.
What is moving in our body is blood.
Mm-hmm.
All the vessels, the blood is moving constantly. That imparts color.
Right.
And there are two things. One is color Doppler, the other one is power Doppler.
Mm-hmm.
Color Doppler gives you red and blue, mm-hmm. blood vessels. Red doesn't mean necessarily artery. Blue doesn't mean necessarily vein.
It is
the direction of flow towards the transducer and away from transducer,
mm-hmm.
which is seen as red and blue.
Okay.
Okay. Now, we have been using this for first trimester basically to find out whether there is any abnormality in the heart or not. Then there is something called the ductus venosus, which is
mm-hmm.
in the liver,
mm-hmm.
which supplies arterial blood,
mm-hmm.
well oxygenated blood to the fetus. That can pick up early chromosomal anomalies. If the ductus venosus waveform is abnormal, then we have a doubt of either congenital cardiac anomalies or chromosomal anomalies, especially Down syndrome. So that is one thing. Secondly,
so we can do that, sir, in the first trimester?
First trimester, 11 to 13.6.
So whenever there is a doubt of suspicion,
always
then
that
we
is one of the things that we
so
do.
So that's at 12 to 13.
Ductus venosus is one of the markers. There are other markers like nuchal translucency,
nasal bone,
ductus venosus, and even tricuspid regurgitation.
Yes,
if you
sir.
See tricuspid regurgitation in first trimester, it again goes in favor of either congenital cardiac anomaly or some chromosomal. So these are the big markers. So that is first trimester. Number two, we can do uterine artery screening. If the uterine artery shows high resistance to the flow of the blood, we
mm-hmm.
call it as high PI,
mm-hmm.
pulsatility index.
Yeah.
Then there is a possibility that patient will develop preeclampsia or IUGR or both
mm-hmm.
later on.
Mm-hmm.
We are doing this screening somewhere around 11 to 14 weeks and we can predict.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, there are false positive results, but it's always good
yeah.
that you can predict these people, patients who are going to get some complications
yeah.
later on. Then in later part of pregnancy, color Doppler is very important to pick up cases of growth restriction, what
mm-hmm.
you call as intrauterine growth restriction, because they have a very high mortality. And it gives us very clear-cut idea. We study the umbilical artery, we study the carotid artery, middle cerebral artery, we study the veins, but umbilical vein and inferior cava, and most important, the ductus venosus,
right.
again in third trimester. If these vessels show abnormality, depending on what all vessels show this abnormality, we can decide when to deliver the baby, because these babies are likely to die in utero if you don't remove them
yeah.
as per the color Doppler finding.
Mm-hmm.
So it has really given us a very good idea that when to get this baby out.
Yeah.
That is one thing. Number two, there are some abnormalities, like nowadays we have very high C-section rate. That is what is being told, though in reality it is not. We get a lot of patients who have repeat when they get pregnant after C-section. They have placenta which is morbidly adherent to the uterine wall.
Mm-hmm.
What we call as a placenta accreta, increta, mm-hmm. or percreta, morbidly
adherent
placenta.
In the next pregnancy.
Yeah. That's a very dangerous situation. Yeah. And color Doppler is one area which whereby we can pick up these people early in third trimester. And we can decide the line of treatment. We can keep the blood ready.
Yeah.
We can have this patient delivered at a big institution, teaching institution, etc. So that we can save the baby as well as the mother.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, sir. I think we can conclude it that minimal three scans, first trimester, second trimester, third trimester. First trimester could be at 10 to 12 weeks.
Yeah.
Second trimester, 18 to 20 weeks. And the third trimester, it is 32 weeks. Apart from that, if the patient says that only one is enough, then it's at 18 weeks, one needs to go ahead with it.
Right.
Color Doppler also has its own significance in the diagnosis.
Okay.
One has to follow the PCPNDT Act judiciously.
Absolutely.
And there is no excuse
in
it. I think ultrasonography, it looks like a simple test, a basic investigation, but it can be a life-saving test.
It's a see-through technology.
Yes.
It's totally revolutionized practice.
Absolutely.
Totally revolutionized, let me tell you. And each and every gynecologist must do ultrasound himself or herself.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you
Thanks
so much.
A lot.